Welcome to the Seica booth here at SMT Connect. I'm delighted to be joined by Luca Corley. Good to see you again, Luca.
Hi, Trevor. Good to see you again.
Yeah. Now, we actually missed you, I think, at Productronica because you brought out this new flying prober called the Pilot VX. Explain what the concept is behind, first of all, the name VX.
Yes. The concept starts from the name because we were used to put the number of probes that the machine can have into the name of the machine. Mm-hmm. X means that the number of probes is now undetermined or basically much more than what it was in the past.
Yeah, I think it goes up to a fantastic, as much as even 60, is that correct?
Even 60, correct. You remember very well. The machine has 8 axes still moving XYZ to go onto the board to be tested. But on every head, we can have a multi-probe mm-hmm. equipped with up to 14 needles.
Wow.
So basically, you can have 56 needles coming from 4 multi-probes, plus additional 4 moving individual probes. Why we did that? Because our platform is more and more deployed for functional test, for flashing, for boundary scan, other than ICT, which is obviously the main job of this machine, or the first job of this machine. So the need of probing with more needles, with more signals onto the board, brought the Seica designers to add this fly pod, is the name of our multi-probe, mm-hmm. and we can have 2 fly pod on each side. So okay. up to 4 fly pods attacking the board exactly at the same time, to combine boundary scan with functional test, with flashing, et cetera, et cetera.
Do these multi-probes have to work within a certain geometry, I mean, to be utilized?
Basically, we design the multi-probe according to the layout of the connector that the board has. Mm-hmm. And our customers are able to change the multi-probe or the fixture of the multi-probe according to the application they have to do. It's an interchangeable system, very easy to do.
Right, right. Yeah. And as you say, so you can interchange the probes on each job, depending on what you're actually testing.
Yes, that's a possibility that our customers can have,
right.
And they can do in a very short time by themselves, with a very minimum time to recalibrate the machine and start for another application.
Right.
The setup time must be very quick because this machine, it's an inline machine.
Yeah.
It's only inline, so it's a machine done for high volumes.
Right.
Yes, high volumes with flying probes.
Wow. It's very impressive. I've never seen anything with as many probes.
And there is another nice feature that we introduced on the Pilot VX platform is the ability to measure for each probing you do on the board, the pressure that we apply,
okay.
and give a report at the end of the test, even for every board if you wish, of how much pressure we apply on every point, so to have an idea of how much you eventually stress, mechanically speaking, the board during your test. Pretty much like the strain test in the bed of nails environment.
Right, right, right. So you're testing the resilience of it going into the board.
Yeah.
There's another application that I didn't know you did, which apparently you've been doing for a very long time.
Yeah.
Which is battery testing using a flying prober.
Yes.
So I'm assuming it's a different architecture,
It's pretty much this architecture just turned 90 degrees because in that case batteries will stay in a horizontal position,
okay.
not in a vertical one. But it's the same type of architecture. Mm-hmm. And in that case, the solution we have is called Pilot BT. Mm-hmm. And it's typically used to test the bonding or the solder joints that are connecting cells together
right.
to make the battery pack.
Right, I see. Okay, so you're testing the solder joints. Okay. And you've been doing that for a very famous
Since
EV company.
More than 10 years. Believe it or not, we provide this type of solutions to a company who basically started the business in the EV since more than 10 years.
Really?
Yeah.
That's incredible. Well, that must be a huge amount of business for you, given the way that company has expanded over the years.
It's an interesting business. Of course, it's booming now. Everybody talks about EVs, but we at Seica, we started when nobody was aware about the future of this type of business.
Right.
But for our technology, it was, let me say, a quick and easy modification of the architecture that that we have.
Right, right, right. Well, you're always coming out with something new, Luca. You're always...
We must.
I know. It's reinvent yourself or die. You know?
Yeah.
But, you know, we love catching up with you because you've always got something new to show us. So, once again, I'm super impressed with this new prober here.
Yeah, I forgot to mention that this machine is 30% faster than the previous generation.
Right.
But, of course, when I say it's a machine for high volumes, it's a machine for mass production, mm-hmm. speed is important.
Right.
So, speed, as you can see from the machine moving there, it's another step ahead to make the flying probe able to replace bed of nails, something
yes.
that we currently do with many customers today.
Yes, yes, yes. And then, you know, and it saves all the, you know, having to get jigs made and everything else that you get with bed of nails.
Flexibility.
Yeah.
Easy setup.
Yeah.
And return on the investment could be much quicker than you can think.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Well, thank you for showing it to us, Luca, and we wish you every success with it.
Thanks for coming, as usual, and see you next time with the next news from Seica.
Okay, thank you.